Jennifer Carroll, a top-ranking Republican in Florida politics, that's until she was forced to resign the office of Lieutenant Governor in scandal. But this daughter of Trinidadian soil is not broken. In this interview with 18 Degrees North, Jennifer Carroll details how she overcame challenges throughout her career in the Navy and in the Florida legislature, rose to the top, lost her way, and is making the climb all over again. Kalib Thompson reports from 26 Degrees North and 80 Degrees West in Fort Lauderdale, Florida.
The Honorable Jennifer Carroll.
It was the shining moment of her career.
I, Jennifer Carroll, do solemnly swear.
In 2010, Jennifer Carroll became the first Black Lieutenant Governor in the state of Florida. Born and raised in Trinidad and Tobago until she was 8 years old, Carroll's early Republican leanings were influenced by her adoptive parents, who emigrated with her to New York's Long Island.
Because they were told that if you weren't Republicans, that you weren't going to get anything done in your street. If you needed a snow shoveled or a water main broke or something, if you weren't registered Republican, they weren't coming to help you.
What is it that made you identify with the Republican Party?
As I got older and seeing what the policies were on both sides, I felt more in line with the Republicans of self-reliance and opportunities. If I want to reach for the sky, then move out of my way for me to achieve that. If I want to achieve the floor as my ceiling, so be it.
Carroll chose to reach for the sky. She embarked on a career as an aviation mechanic in the U.S. Navy. It was here where she met her husband of 30 years. The Navy also relocated her from New York to Florida, where poor political representation inspired her own interest in politics.
Recognizing that we had one of the poorest districts in the state. And I wondered why, when this representative had equal access to bring about a change, that she wasn't very responsive. So when I retired from the Navy, that was my direction, was to run for office at that time.
And she did. After retiring at the fifth highest rank in the U.S. Navy and spending a few years in private business and state politics, Carroll became the first Republican woman to be elected to the Lieutenant Governor's office in Florida, second in command to the controversial Republican Governor Rick Scott, a role, she says, that consumed her.
I never slept. It's interesting that my staff, they will get emails from me at 2 o'clock in the morning and they go, do you ever sleep? But the ball was always rolling. I was always thinking about this, that, and the other.
As Lieutenant Governor, Carroll focused on job creation, the military, and investments in commercial space programs. She also kept her sights on the Caribbean, leading a U.S. trade mission to her homeland, Trinidad and Tobago, in 2012. But halfway through her term in office, Carroll found herself embroiled in a high-profile scandal. A charity group, Allied Veterans, that she represented when she owned a public relations firm, became the subject of an FBI probe. The nonprofit was accused of being a front for illegal gambling operations and misrepresenting how much it donated to charity.
According to the IRS, the fundraising centers were nothing more than internet casinos, which operated slot machines in violation of Florida's gambling laws.
Carroll herself appeared in an advertisement promoting Allied Veterans, even while serving as Lieutenant Governor.
Allied Veterans, mm-hmm. Can you just address how it is that you became involved with them?
My job for them was on the outside. I didn't have any knowledge of their financials or anything like that. Then when I was vetted to be the Lieutenant Governor, all of my clients were disclosed to the governor back in 2010. I wasn't arrested. My business wasn't looked at because I didn't have any connection with their internal operations.
Carroll was interviewed but never charged. Nevertheless, in March of 2013, following the FBI's highly publicized raid on the offices of Allied Veterans, Governor Rick Scott asked for her resignation.
Yesterday, Lieutenant Governor Carroll resigned in an effort to keep her former affiliation with the company from distracting from our efforts.
What was your relationship like with him?
Well, I thought it was good up until the time he asked me to resign. So, but I was on a ticket with him at his request, and I got off the ticket at his request.
Immediately, I hereby resign the office of Lieutenant Governor.
In light of that, in light of the fact that you were very gracious in your statements that you made afterwards, do you feel like he threw you under the bus a little bit?
Yes, a little bit. through and run over and run over again.
Even after leaving the lieutenant governorship, controversy surrounding Carroll's time in office continued. Just recently, Carroll was publicly criticized for leading a review that kept Florida's Stand Your Ground law intact.
And in November, this Jennifer Carroll task force made its recommendation. They said the law should remain intact. The Honorable Jennifer Carroll, Lieutenant Governor, saying hands off the Florida Stand Your Ground law. That was 3 weeks before she would resign in disgrace.
That law sparked protests around the U.S. after Florida Neighborhood Watch Captain George Zimmerman disobeyed police instructions, pursuing and ultimately shooting and killing teenager Trayvon Martin.
The people say!
You had made a recommendation in your task force report that community watch people should not be getting out and pursuing anyone. They should stay in their car, call police. In light of recommendations like that, do you think that a ball was dropped in this Zimmerman case?
Well, we made a number of recommendations that the legislature should have picked up on, but apparently that wasn't their primary focus. The bad thing with the Zimmerman case is that it injected Stand Your Ground where that was not his defense. It was a justifiable use of force, which been in the statute since the 1800s.
One of the jurors in the case actually said that Stand Your Ground was the reason, that one juror who said she was trying to kind of, she thought he had committed murder, that Zimmerman had committed murder.
Well, he did.
From one controversy to the next, Carroll has kept standing. She attributes her resilience to a strong family support system.
Luckily, I have a great husband that I've been able to have a confidant in him, and he's a family man, and he doesn't care for politics whatsoever, but I'll be able to share things with him. I gave everything to the state and the people, and I forewent my family and the time with them, so I'm grateful to have the time to do the things I'm doing for them now.
This shift in focus means Carroll spends more time with her three grown-up children, including her oldest son, Nolan, who plays Major League Football with the Miami Dolphins.
His dad and I have tried to instill in him, take opportunities to appreciate the small victories. You may have a good day today, take joy in that day. Tomorrow may be a bad day, but at least take joy in today.
And Carroll is taking her own good advice. She's agreed to serve as the new chief operating officer of a small arms manufacturer. But this time around, she's looking for a better work-life balance, listening to soca artists like Marshall Montano and cooking Caribbean favorites like roti, callaloo, and cuckoo.
You work so hard that you may never enjoy the things that you're working hard for. And that's what I share with your listeners as well, too. Every day, one little victory, take joy in that and appreciate what that has brought to your life.
The preceding segment was brought to you by
Grace.
Grace Coconut Water presents Quality Time with the world's fastest woman.
My life is fast. Even when I'm not on the track, I'm busy running around. I always take the time to refresh.
Life is fast. Hydrate well with Grace Coconut Water.
Finally, a way to help control your diabetes. Introducing Caribbean Dreams Cinnamon Mint Diabetic Tea. Caribbean Dreams Cinnamon Mint Diabetic Tea is all natural and sweetened with stevia leaves, a plant sweetener. It's safe for diabetics. Cinnamon increases the body's ability to regulate blood sugar. Peppermint is high in antioxidants and soothes the stomach. Take control of your diabetes with Caribbean Dreams Cinnamon Mint Diabetic Tea.
'Twas a night when all was still, that pastry passions experienced a thrill. It could have been the beautiful cakes that made this special little doll awake. A night to indulge in freshly baked products and desserts was enough to make this doll smirk. Now I see why even she couldn't resist taking a bite from the goodies on the Pastry Passions list. Pastry Passions is everybody's passion.
So this is where we bring 18 Degrees North to a close for this week. Join us online at www.18degreesnorth.tv. Like us on Facebook. Follow us on Twitter and keep connected to the Caribbean. From all of us here at 18 Degrees North, thanks for watching. I'm Zara Burton. See you next time.